So this is lecture number 9 on unit 2. We are going to see analysis of singly reinforced rectangular beam. As I discussed yesterday, in the design of reinforced concrete structure, there are two types of problem. One is analysis and design. First we will do analysis, then we go for a design. I also discussed about what is you mean by singly reinforced beam, right? So yesterday we worked out two problems. Today we will go on further. So this is the third one. Now question is like this. Show that the limiting depth of neutral axis. Please pay a careful attention. Here there is a given as a limiting depth or critical depth. Both are one and the same. Limiting depth of neutral axis or critical depth of neutral axis. For a rectangular cross section reinforced with Fe 500 grade steel is 0.46. You have to prove this, right? What is limiting depth of neutral axis? That is XU limit or XE max, right? The answer is already given. This 0.46 is given, but you have to prove it, which I have already shown you. This critical depth of neutral axis or limiting depth of neutral axis always comes from your strain diagram for a balanced section. If you see the strain diagram for a balanced section, from that only you can derive this equation. We will see how to derive it. So as usual, the first given data is you have to do for a Fe 500 grade steel. So that is the only data given, Fe 500 steel, for Fe 500 steel. What is the XU limit? That is 0.460. That's what you have to prove, right? Is there any doubt in this question itself? I'm pretty sure the question is pretty straightforward question. There should not be any doubt. But in case if you have any doubt, you can ask. Okay. So that means you have to find out the critical neutral axis or limiting depth of neutral axis. That is XE max or XE limit. That's what you have to find out. So as I told you, XE limit or XE max always comes from either strain diagram for a balanced section. Now we will take up that one, balance section here. I will zoom it. Okay, so here if you see, this is the width of the section. This is the effective depth. Small d is the effective depth and capital D is the overall depth. Effective depth level only, you have a steel reinforcement placed. And the neutral axis depth, this is called the critical neutral axis depth. The limiting depth of neutral axis, XU limit. So since from here, from top compression fiber to the center of the steel is D, that is effective depth. So below the neutral axis, the depth is D minus XU limit. Okay. So from this two triangle, for XU limit, you have the strain at the extreme compression fiber in the concrete is 0.0035. Similarly, for D minus XE limit depth, in the extreme tensile fiber and at the level of the steel, the strain in the steel is 0.002 plus 0.87 Fy divided by ES. You know, Fy divided by 1.15 or 0.87 Fy, both are one and the same. So in your board, you may be seeing Fy divided by 1.15 ES plus 0.002, both are one and the same. Okay, this everybody knows, right? And you know this Young's modulus of steel is taken as 200 GPa or 2 into 10 power 5 MPa. MPa is nothing but Newton per millimeter square. This everybody knows. Suppose in your problem Young's modulus is not given, you are supposed to take 200 GPa or 2 into 10 power 5 Newton per millimeter square. Okay. Now, knowing this, you know from the similar triangle principle, from strain diagram, this strain diagram, using similar triangle principle, you can write for XE limit, you have 0.0035 from this triangle, upper triangle. From the lower triangle, for D minus XE limit, you have this one, 0.002 plus Fy divided by 1.15 ES. And this is given in your, this is also given in assumption page number 69. This is also given. This is also given. Okay, page number 69. If you read the assumption 2 and 5, these two values are given. Okay, so pretty much everything given in the code itself, you just have to know how to derive the equation. Now if you rearrange this, I am taking d minus xv limit this side, xv limit on the other side. I am rearranging this equation, right? D minus xv limit into 0.0035. If this one goes to other side, xv limit into the numerator, 0.002 plus fy into 1.1. Now this xv limit into 0.0035, I can take in the other side. That will become like this, 0.0035 d xc limit, because here minus 0.0035 coming on this side will become 0.0055, adding this one and this one, 0.0055. This is 0.87 fy by s. Now we can xc limit by d is equal to this value. So if you do this, if you substitute for fy, what is given? 500 MPa. Young's modulus of steel, you know, 2 into 10 power 5 MPa. So if you substitute, you are getting 0.456. So that is equivalent to 0.46. So therefore, XC limit is equal to 0.46D. As I told you earlier, in the code, in page number 70, XC limit by D for all the grades of steel is given for with a precision of 2 decimal places. That is why you may get a value lesser than what is given in the code. But this is exact value, 0.456 exact value. So if you round down, it will become 0.46. Okay. So this kind of question also will come in the examination. So you should know how to derive it. Any doubt in this one? Anybody? Anybody having any doubt? Okay. So if not, you can. This one, next problem we are going to then. You read the problem very carefully. Most of the time, students make mistake in reading the question itself. They will find an answer to a question which is not asked. So you have to read the question very carefully. So here it is given, a rectangular beam of 250 mm by 500 mm is reinforced with 3 numbers of 20 mm diameter bars at an effective depth of 500 mm. Remember, the bars are placed at an effective depth. It is not saying effective cover, it is saying effective depth of 500 mm. Using M20 and Fe415, find the limiting ultimate moment of resistance of the beam. So what is asked? Limiting. You have to be careful here. Limiting value is there. Limiting ultimate moment of resistance of the beam. What is limiting ultimate moment of resistance? How do we represent by which symbol? Limiting ultimate moment of resistance. Anybody can answer.
MUR limit, sir.
Very good. It is a MUR. MUR means just ultimate moment of resistance. Limiting ultimate moment of resistance means MUR limit, which is a fixed value for a particular grade of concrete and steel. Okay. So now we will see how to do that. Anyway, most of you answered correctly. That's very good. So now this 500 is what? What is this 500? In terms of simple symbol, whether it is d dash or d, small d.
Small d, sir.
Small d, small yes. D, yeah. So here the given data are, you have been given the width of the beam is 250 mm. Width is given 250 mm, and 550 mm is the overall depth, because here rectangular beam of size 250 mm, 550 mm is given. That is, this is 550 mm. This is the cross section of the beam. Is reinforced with 3 numbers of 20 mm diameter bars. Here 3 numbers of 20. These are 3 numbers of 20 bars at an effect. This is AST. AST means 3 into 5 by 4, 20 square will come. Okay, that is AST, area of tensile steel. At an effective depth of 500 mm, this is from top compression fiber to the centroid of the tensile steel. Effective depth is 500 mm is given here. Using M20 and Fe415, find limiting ultimate moment of resistance of the beam. Okay, is there any doubt in the question itself or in the given data itself? If anybody have any question in the given data, please let me know. Okay, so we'll continue. So you write down all the given data with the symbol. So you know, B is given as 250 mm, small b is the width of the pin, small d is the 500 mm, this is effective depth. Remember, the characteristic strength of concrete, M20 grade concrete, represented by FCK. So if you want to zoom a little bit, I am just to zoom it. Okay. FCK is 220 MPa, or M20 grade concrete is given, and Fe415 steel is given. So this is Fy is 415 MPa. Remember, Fe415 corresponds to this characteristic strength of steel, that is a yield strength of steel, 415. M20 is a grade of concrete, that is characteristic strength of concrete, compressive strength at 28 days. FCK is 20 MPa. Don't reverse it. Some of you are understanding wrongly. The small number will always be a concrete grade, and the bigger will be always a grade of steel. Okay. So at least remember by that. The smaller value is a concrete, and the bigger value is a steel grade. Now you are asked to find out what is the MUR limit. Sometimes they may say MU limit or MUR limit, both are one and the same. Okay. So now. Now what we will do, we have to find out ME limit. So second step, to find XU max by D and MUR limit. Now, because you have to find out limiting ultimate moment of resistance, you can actually, you can directly write, if you know the answer to this one, I have derived the equation, the equation was derived, 0.143, 0.138, 0.133, FCK PD square, like that. We will see how to derive it. So first, we find out XU max. What is the value of XU max by D? For Fe415, what is the value of XU max by D? So, you know, from G1.1C, page number 96, your ME limit value is given there. You can see 0.36 XU limit by D, 1 minus 0.42 XU limit by D into FCK BD square. It is given in your code. So, I will show you in the code itself. Here, 96. So here, MU limit formula is here. Are you able to see MU limit formula here? Here, limiting. Moment of resistance, 0.36 XU max by D, 1 minus 0.42 XU max by D, FCK VD square. Okay, this is the value you have to take. So that's what I have written here. Okay, now FCK value, you know, 20 MPa, BV, you know, 250 mm, small d square, small d, you know, 500 mm, 0.36. Now, only unknown here, XC limit by D, here also XC limit by D. You know, XC limit by D for Fe415 steel, XC limit by D is 0.48 from page number 70 of IS 456. So, substitute for 0.48 here as well as here. What you will get? FCK BD square, 0.36 into 0.48, 1 minus 0.48, 0.42 into 0.48. If you reduce all this thing, you will get 0.138 FCK BD square. Please remember this value, because every time you cannot derive it, you can directly write ME limit is equal to 0.138 FCK BD square. Unless they ask you to derive this equation itself, you can directly find out ME limit is equal to 0.138 FCK BD square. Right? This is for Fe415 steel. Suppose if you have Fe500 steel, you have ME limit is equal to 0.133 FCK BD square. Similarly, for Fe250, you have 0.143 or something like that, 143 or 143, I forgot. You can go back and refer to the slide that we have in the lecture number 6. We have discussed how to obtain ME limit value for a various grade of steel. So for Fe415, it is 0.138 FCK BD square. Now in this, you substitute all the known value. So ME limit is equal to 0.138, FCK is 20, B is 250, D square is 500 square. You are getting 172.5 into 10 power 6 Newton millimeters. And in general, we always write in terms of kilo Newton meters. So how will you convert this 172.5 into 10 power 6 Newton millimeter into kilonewton meter.
0.001.
And that is 1 millimeter is equal to 0.001 meter.
Meter.
That is correct. Yeah, that is correct. So you have, you can easily write 172.5 because 1000 Newton is 1 kilonewton. So 10 power 3 is gone and 1000 millimeter is 1 meter. So 172.5 kilonewton meters. This is the requested answer. Limiting moment of ultimate moment of resistance is equal to 172.5 kilonewton meters. Okay. Anybody having any doubt, please ask. This is the answer for the question. Finally, you can write down limiting moment of resistance equal to 172.5 kilonewton meter. Anybody having any doubt? See, this is also coming from code only. And XE limit by DE also coming from code only. You just have to know from in the code where these equations are. Otherwise, you will simply turn the pages in the code. Time will be passed. You will not be able to do anything. But remember, in GATE exam or any competitive examination, they are not going to give you the code book, right? So you have to know these values by heart. ME limit mean 0.138 FCK BD square. So from that, you can directly, you can write down the answer, right? Any doubt, anybody? Okay, so we will go ahead. Now it's a homework time. Same problem, whatever we have discussed here, right? I will put the PDF today, so you can refer. Same problem. Suppose if find the change in ME limit value, if you have grade of steel is changed to Fe500 and Fe250. Please, all of you, work it out from the beginning. Don't directly write down the answer. I want you to derive for each case, this case also and this case also. What is the value of ME limit? Okay. Then you compare with the result we obtained earlier. For ME limit, how much is it? 172.5 for Fe415. For Fe500 it is how much? For Fe250 how much? You find it. Okay. Okay. Now, next problem. Again, read it very carefully. Find the moment of resistance of RC beam of size 230 mm by 500 mm reinforced with three numbers of 16 mm diameter mild steel bars at bottom at a clear cover of 32 mm. The grade of concrete is M20. Okay. So please, once again, you read the problem carefully. Find the moment of resistance of RC beam of size 230 mm by 500 mm. Now, is it a overall depth or a effective depth? Find the moment of resistance of RC beam of size 230 mm is the width, 500 mm is the overall depth, because there is nothing mentioned about effective here. Is reinforced with three numbers of 16 mm diameter mild steel bars at bottom at a clear cover of 32 mm and the grade of steel is given as, the grade of concrete is given as M20. When you read the problem, be very careful. Mild steel is given, that is Fe250, and these bars are placed at a clear cover of 32 mm. Okay, and grade of concrete is given as M20. So now, to write the given, I want all of you to write the answer only in step-by-step manner in your answer script, in your exam and all. If you don't write step, I will directly cut down everything, because I am trying to spend time with all of you with systematically how to go step by step, and I want you to write everything in step by step manner. Okay, so first, given data, as usual, you have a width is 230 mm, overall depth is given as 500 mm and reinforced with three number of 16 mm diameter bar. This is three number of 16 mm diameter bar, that is AST, at bottom at a clear cover of 32 mm. Okay, so we will discuss now how to find out effective cover and effective depth. So B is given as 230 mm, overall depth is 500 mm, and Fy is 250 MPa, that I told you, know, mild steel means Fe 250 steel, that is why Fy is 250 MPa. So please remember this point. This point, mild steel means Fe 250. Okay, this one you should be very clear. Many times students forget about it, but it is Fe 250 steel is Fy 250 MPa. Now how area of steel, this AST is equal to 3 into whatever the diameter given to you here. Okay, 3 number of steel is given and the diameter of each bar is 16 mm, so pi by 4, 16 square into 3. For you should remember, for 16 mm dia the area is almost 201 millimeter square, so 3 into 201 is 6603 millimeter square. Okay, so now what is asked? Find the ultimate moment of resistance of RFC. What, sorry, ultimate moment of resistance and moment of resistance, both are one and the same. Mild steel, okay, AST is 3 into pi by 4, 16 square, that is coming out to 603 millimeter square. Now find the moment of resistance. What you have to find out? Resistance number 15. So so FCK is 20 MPa given, clear cover is given as 32 mm, this clear cover is given as 32 mm. Okay, these are all the given data. Any doubt in given data? Anybody having any doubt in the given data itself? Because if you wrong given data, if you make a mistake in the given data itself, everything else you do it will be wrong. So at least in the given data you should write it, write down very, you should draw the diagram, you should also write down in terms of words. Okay, so first remember, in any question of finding out the moment of resistance, see, moment of resistance has two formula. One is governed by steel, another one is governed by concrete. So if your section is under reinforced section, your moment of resistance you will calculate using steel formula. Suppose if section is coming out to be a over reinforced section, then your failure is governed by a concrete, so you will use concrete formula, right? So in order to find out whether the given problem is an under reinforced section or over reinforced section, how will you do it? You have to either, as I told you yesterday, two method. You find out AST limit, and AST you already know here. So if AST is less than AST limit, it is under reinforced section. Or otherwise, you find out XC max, that is critical depth of neutral axis. Then find out the actual depth of neutral axis, that is XU. If XU is less than XC max or XC limit, that is under reinforced section. If it is more than XC max, it is over reinforced section. So first, after writing given data, first you find out what is the critical depth of neutral axis. Effective depth means, here the overall depth is given, effective depth is not given to you. Overall depth is given as 500 mm. Now you have to, effective depth is overall depth minus effective cover, that you already know. For example, so here from the top fiber till the center of the steel is called effective depth, that you can obtain from overall depth minus effective cover. Now what is given to you is a clear cover, it's not a effective cover. So ideally speaking, your this is your effective cover. Okay, from center to here, this is effective cover. So obviously because here this stirrup diameter is not given to you, in most of the book they may say clear cover is till the steel, at the bottom of the steel here, up to here. I will take a different color. Suppose let us say at the bottom of the steel here, this is called clear cover, but originally clear cover is only up to the bottom of stirrups here. But because stirrup diameter is not known, you can take clear cover because that's very small dimension, so you can take this itself. So this here, so clear cover is The distance from the bottom most fiber in the tension fiber till the bottom of the rod main tensile steel, that is called clear cover. So, but effective cover is till the center of the steel. So, if you have to add half the diameter of the steel, then you will get effective cover. So, that is why 500 D is 500 minus this effective cover is nothing but clear cover plus half the diameter of the main steel. That is this. So if you do this, 500 minus clear cover is given as 32 mm, and is half the diameter of the steel given main steel is 16/2. So 32 plus 8 is 40. For 500 minus 40 is 460 mm. Any doubt in this one? Anybody? Please ask. If you have doubt, you ask. Anybody having any doubt?
Sir, explain effective depth.
Effective depth nothing but the it is a distance from the topmost compression fiber here till the centroid of the steel. Centroid of the steel. Okay, that is effective depth. Now, effective depth is not given to you directly, but it is given indirectly. The overall depth is given as 500 mm. Okay, from here, from the bottommost fiber till the top is 500 mm, and this clear cover is given. This clear cover means from the bottom most till the bottom of this bottom. This is the diameter of the steel. At the bottom level, this is called clear cover. That is 32 mm given. Okay. We want this is clear cover. We want, or you can write one more sentence. Okay. Effective cover is. Effective cover is equal to clear cover plus half the diameter, okay, of main steel. So that is what I am writing in this effective cover is this one, clear cover plus half the diameter. Okay, so I will get this distance. What is this from the bottom? This is 40 mm I got. So total is 500 minus 40. This effective depth is 460 mm. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that is effective depth. So please remember, clear cover plus half the diameter of the main steel will give you effective cover. So original depth minus effective cover will give you effective depth small d. Okay. So you know. So that is what I marked here. This is 460 is marked here. Okay, you can see here this 460. This is a 460 from here to the center of the steel. Okay, for mild steel from page number 70 of IS 456-2000, XU limit by D is 0.53. So what is the value of XU limit? 0.53 into D. So 0.53 into D is 460 mm. We found out from here. That is coming out to be 243.8 millimeters. Okay. So see, unless you have a code, you will not know all these values, or you should memorize these values. Okay. Only there are three values: 0.53, 0.48, 0.46. So you should know for what steel which value it is. The more ductile the steel, your this value is higher. Mild steel is more ductile, so you have 0.53 highest value. Fe415 is in between mild steel and Fe500. That is why you have 0.48. Fe500 is the hardest steel. That is why you have 0.46. Okay. So now XU limit is 243.8 millimeters. That is the XU max or XU limit. So then you find out, next step is to find out the actual depth of neutral axis. That is called XU. XU is actual depth of neutral axis. This is the standard. This is the for a balanced section. What is the critical depth of neutral axis or the limiting depth of neutral axis? 243.8 mm. But what is the actual depth of neutral axis for this one? Is because this value is for a, if you provide AST is equal to AST limit. But you have not provided AST limit here. We have to find out what value of AST you provided. For that AST, you should know what is the value of XU. Is that clear? If you provided AST equal to AST limit, this XU limit is fine. But we are not providing this 3 number of 16 mm diameter bar. It is not AST limit. It may be less than AST or it may be more than AST limit. So we have to find out. So how to find out the depth of axial neutral axis? This also given in your code from G1.1A, page number 96 of IS456. I will show you that here. This is the equation. Okay, this is G1.1. See, remember here we are solving rectangular section. That is why it is given rectangular section. And we are doing singly reinforced section, that is section without compression reinforcement. If with compression reinforcement means that is a doubly reinforced beam. So G1.1 stands for section without compression reinforced means you have singly reinforced section. Beams are reinforced only at its tensile zone. So at that point, 1.1a, the depth of neutral axis here, XU, depth of neutral axis formula is given here, XU by D is equal to 0.87 Fy AST, 0.36 FCK B into D. So this equation also given in the code. So that's what we are going to use. So XU by D is equal to 0.87 Fy AST, 0.36 FCK B. We are interested to find out XU. So this D and this D can cancel it. So that other unnecessary calculation. Okay, we cancelled it. So from this you substitute Fy, you know, Fy is Fe2 because it's a mild steel bar. It is 250. AST we know 3 into 201 603. FCK we know because it is 20 grade, it is 20. B is given as 230 mm. You substitute all this thing here. You are getting 79.2 millimeters. All of you, please go back and work it out. Don't simply listen and then leave it out. You should work it out yourself later on. Go and check whether this calculated value and all correct or not, because sometimes I can also make mistake. It's not that I am perfect. I can also make mistake. So right, find out XC value, 0.87 Fy AST divided by 0.36 FCKB. So XC is coming out to be 79.2. So you already know from the previous page, we already found out what is the value of XC max, because as XC value is 79.2. XC max, how much we found out? 200 and something value, right? 214 or something like that. So since your XC value is less than XC max, as we discussed yesterday, it is an under reinforced section. Therefore, steel will yield first. That is mean the stress in the steel will be 0.87 Fy. Is that understood? Any doubt here? If there is any doubt, please ask. So if you want to find out moment of resistance, the procedure is simple. You have to find out the actual depth of neutral axis, that is called XU. You have to find out the limiting depth of neutral axis, that is called XU max or XU limit. You compare this. If XU is less than XU max or XU limit, that is called under reinforced section. In the under reinforced section, steel will yield first. So okay, this is the second step to find out XC value and the type of section. This is XC value 79.2 and the type of section is under reinforced section. Okay, that we found out. So we have to use the steel, because in under reinforced section, I showed you video also, when the section is under reinforced, first yielding will start play, the crack will start developing at the tension zone where the steel is placed, and then steel will start yielding. That is why steel will yield first in under reinforced section. But in the over reinforced section, concrete will fail first. At that time, steel will have a stress lesser than 0.87 Fy. Okay, so now determination of ultimate moment of resistance. This is the given asked question. Since MUR is equal to tensile force multiplied by lever arm. Actually, tensile force is FST is the stress in the steel multiplied by area of steel will give you force. This first two terms is called tensile force. All the tensile force taken by steel is stress in the tensile steel multiplied by the area of tensile steel provided multiplied by the lever arm. Lever arm is nothing but Z, that is D minus 0.4 x. So FST is 0.87 Fy because it is an under reinforced section of 0.87 Fy AST. Into Z is T minus 0.40 XU, or you can also directly use this formula. I will show you the formula here. See here, if the value of XU by, are you able to see this PDF, everybody?
sir?
See, if the value of x u by d is less than the limiting value, limiting value is x u max by d, okay? So either x u by d is less than x u max by d, or x u is less than x u max, both are one and the same, okay? What they are saying is, okay, here either x u is less than x u max or x u divided by d less than x u max by d, both are one and same, okay? So here they are saying if the value of x u by d is less than the x u limiting value, means x u limit by d or x u max by d, calculate the moment of resistance by the following formula. Here is the formula, okay? You can use this formula also. M is equal to 0.87 Fy Ast into D into 1 minus Ast into Fy divided by FCK BD or BD FCK. So you can use this equation also, or you can use this because both are one and the same, okay? I simply say, if you substitute, instead of XU, you substitute this XU here, you will get the same equation, okay? So MUR is equal to 0.87. Fy is 250 MPa, Ast is 603, effective depth is 460, minus 0.42, XE value is 79.2, that is coming out to be 55.967 into 10 power 6 Newton milliliters. So remember, it is only XE, it is not XE max. Many times people make mistake of putting XE max here, it is not XE max. In the equation of ultimate moment of resistance, you will have only XU, not XU max. Whenever you are finding out limiting ultimate moment of resistance, that XU will become XU max. But if you are finding out ultimate moment of resistance alone, this is, remember somebody asked in the lecture 3, when you have MU is equal to, we saw two equations. MU is equal to 0.36 FCK XU D into D minus 0.42 XU. And another equation was this, right? When to use this equation? When to use this equation? Suppose if your section is coming out your under reinforced section, then the steel will attain the yield first, 0.87 Fy will be the first. So that is why we use this equation. Okay? Right? We will use this equation. Suppose if XU is coming out to more than XE max, we will use this one. At that time, we will not use this one. Okay, that is the difference. So MUR is equal to 55.967 10 power 6 Newton millimeter, or MUR is equal to 55.967 kilo Newton meter. Remember, 1 kilo Newton meter is equal to 10 power 6 Newton millimeters. Okay, I hope right now you are in fifth semester. Now you should not have any confusion in the units, change of units. If you have still confusion, please go back and rectify it immediately. You should not have any doubt in changing the units. Okay, any doubt? So this is the answer. 55.967 kilo Newton meter is the moment of resistance of the beam. Any doubt so far? Okay, homework for you, all of you. If the steel grade is Fe415, then what is the value of moment of resistance? So this is your homework. Is that clear? If anybody having any doubt, please ask. So as I told you, you can use the same this equation, or you can use the equation from the code. That also you can use. That is this. This is from page number 96 of the code. This formula also you can use here. Okay, you can find out the same. Okay.